This is going to be a pretty long video, I think. Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be talking about 15 things that really grind my gears. If you're new here, my name is Giz Edwards and I'm a lucid dreaming coach and an entrepreneur based here in the UK. And on this channel, we talk about lucid dreaming, entrepreneurship and other things such as this video to make your life more enjoyable, fulfilling and relaxed. Although this doesn't really fall into any of those categories. Now, with that out of the way, let's talk about those pesky gear grinding things. First of all, it's probably good to point out the fact that I am a pretty stoic person. I don't really show emotion on the outside, and to be honest, I rarely feel it on the inside. However, these things on my list are things that I internalize greatly. So if I see one of these things or one of these things happen, I don't say or do anything about it. I just go, and I make a note next time I see that person. Oh yeah, they did this. Yeah, passive aggressive. Okay, let's crack into it. Number one, people who use the term toning. Toning, in reference to toning your body so you can see your muscles. That doesn't exist. My undergraduate degree was related to physiology. It was a sports science degree. And it was common for people on my course to also get annoyed at this sentence or this saying. I just want to do a little bit of toning. I don't mind the average Joe saying it. Like, if I ask somebody what are their fitness goals, they say, I just want to get a bit more toned. That's fine. But if you see a workout program or you see a trainer who claims to give you this advice, you will tone your body. They are full of it. You see it all the time on YouTube. Legs, bums and tums, toning video. It's not okay. It's not right. Okay. This is how body works. Muscle, fat, skin. If you lose fat, it shows more muscle through your skin. So there's no such thing as toning. There's fat loss, and a toning exercise doesn't exist. There's two ways to show more muscle: build more muscle or lose fat. That's it. Okay, build more muscle. Literally do that. Resistance training. Have a weight training program or something. Or lose fat. And the best way to lose fat is diet, not exercise. Whilst I'm on the subject of health and fitness, number two, people who claim spot fat removal. Again, I see this on YouTube quite a lot. There's no such thing as spot fat removal. Meaning if you have a podgy belly, no matter how many crunches you do, it won't get rid of the fat on your stomach. Your body stores fat in the way it wants to, and it also gets rid of that fat in the reverse order. Think of it like storing boxes into a truck. You put it into the back and you keep pushing boxes in. And once the truck is full, you can't just reach the back box that you put in first. Now think of the truck as your body and the boxes as fat. It stores it in a particular order. And even when the truck is full, you can't grab the back box to get rid of the abdominal fat. It just doesn't work that way. Again, I don't mind the average Joe thinking that this is a thing, because why would they know any different? But if you're a specialist, like an exercise trainer or a workout program or a personal fitness person, just don't. Okay, number three, people who take food off my plate without asking. Who do you think you are? Number four, people who crush a stack of poppadoms at the Indian restaurant without asking anyone. Who do you think you are? Number five, companies that sell standard items or stuff as a premium. I'm thinking specifically at Specsavers for this, which is where I get my glasses from here in the UK. When you buy a new pair of glasses from Specsavers, they offer you like an add-on additional thing. Oh, do you want the anti-glare and anti-scratch resistance coating for an extra £10 or however much it is? And you say, yes, please. Which is why sometimes you see like green reflections in my glasses, or this one here is purple a little bit here. See, there's green there and there's a little bit of purple. Can't really see it in this light. You can definitely see the green. That's because I said yes, please to that. What I want to say is, why is that not the default? Why do I have to say yes to the anti-scratch and anti-glare resistance coating? Why don't you just sell that as standard? Have the glasses £10 more expensive and have the option of getting rid of it. Maybe that's a better option. Less people will say no. Maybe there's a law or something about it. I don't know. It's just annoying. Okay, number six, people who insist that you're not okay when you're actually okay. As I said at the start of the video, I'm very stoic, so I tend to stay quite straight-faced when I'm talking to people. But it's not the same as a resting bitch face. I don't have a resting bitch face. I just have a plain Jane face, okay? And I've had people in the past asking me if I'm okay. And I say, yeah, I'm okay. And they say, you're not okay, are you? I say, no, I'm okay. Seriously. And no matter how much you say it, or no matter how you say you're okay, they won't believe you. Until you get to the point, no, seriously, I am okay. I am okay. And the more you say that, the less okay you sound. It's like, are you okay? Yeah, I'm okay. You're not okay though, are you? No, I'm okay. No, seriously, I'm okay. No, seriously, I'm okay. I'm okay. I am okay. That's what it feels like. Number 7, people who don't take no for an answer. Come on, I won't take no for an answer. You wanna bet? I feel like Ron Swanson in this moment. Number 8, people with an education superiority complex. One of the things that I hate more than anything on the planet is those who belittle others because of something that they don't know. And I just think of the thing of like, well, you don't know what you don't know. Well, what do you think of the tectonic plate activity under Japan at the moment? Oh, I don't know about that. Well, what do you mean you don't know about that? It's just common knowledge. Well, it might be common knowledge, but it's not common knowledge to me, is it? It puts someone else down to make themselves feel higher, and it's sick. You know that guy in Good Will Hunting where he's like, well, what do you mean you don't blah, 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 blah. And Matt Damon steps in and just owns him. Yeah, that kind of guy. Look, just because you don't know something doesn't mean you don't know anything. I could say the same thing. Like, what do you think about the tectonic plate activities? Actually, what I want to ask you is, what do you think of the rat-faced lady from Bemessia in Final Fantasy IX? What was her name again? What do you mean you don't know any of the words I just said? It's Freya, by the way. It's Freya. Number 9, people who are rude to service industry workers. I hate the way that Tesco's has an impact on the environment. It's disgusting the way that they pollute the air and the environment the way that they do. Not to mention, the price of the stuff in Tesco's is so high that it's just sick. They need to rectify that. £22.49, please. Cash or card. You know, it doesn't make sense. I used to work in the service industry, and the amount of times people treat you like a slave is unbelievable. I feel sorry for waiters and waitresses most. They work incredibly long hours, high stress job. They cart food back and forth from a kitchen to you via a platter so you can enjoy your food, and you've some reason think it's okay to be rude to them. I don't get that. If you want a fancier service, go to a fancier restaurant. This is Wetherspoons, mate. Number 10, people who say pacifically when they mean specifically. I could write a whole list of stuff like that, but this one specifically gets on my nerves. Number 11, glorifying hangovers. Mate, I got so smashed last night, I don't remember a thing. Top 5 drunkest I've ever been. Good for you. Like, why are we... This is a typically British thing that people do. It's not cool. I don't care about your hangover. Just means you poisoned yourself too much last night. That's it. That's it. For example, it's like me saying, oh, dude, I feel so horrible today because I ate 17 toads. Well, what do you think was going to happen? Doesn't make sense to me. Number 12, people who belittle issues from other people. If someone is reaching out to you because of an issue that they have, be it mental health, physical, workload or something, they need help and advice. What they don't want is to say, you think your day's bad? Well, my day, I had to scoop out my own, you know, whatever it is. If someone's reaching out to you, offer help. That's why they're reaching out. Don't use it as a contest for how bad each of your lives are. It's stupid. Number 13, people who have a go at you for not doing something. Just for the record, I have never voted for anything in my life, nor have I been vaccinated. And the simple reason is, number 1, I don't care about voting. It doesn't even enter my brain or leave my brain. Number 2, I don't trust the government. That's it. But when you tell people these things, they lose their mind. Especially when it comes to like voting and vaccinations. When it comes to voting, especially the Brexit thing. It's like, oh, who did you vote for? I didn't vote.
What? What do you mean you didn't vote? What's wrong with you? Don't you want your choice to go? Oh, it's absolutely reprehensible.
Or even more annoyingly, when you're getting the COVID-19 vaccination. Oh, I'm not.
What? Do you want everyone to die?
No. No, I don't. What kind of stupid question is that? I just don't like the idea of medical coercion from the government and my peers, my friends. I think the government will try and take away as much power from the people as they possibly can, especially before the next economic crash. Because if they do that before it crashes, they can take more power. They have more power when the economy goes back up. Just for the record, even if I wanted to take the COVID-19 vaccination, I can't because I'm allergic to something, a medicine that they said, if you're allergic to this, don't take this. So I've been advised not to take it. Number 14, people who go off at you when you mention any kind of conspiracy theory. Let's take the example in number 13, when I said I think that the government will try and take away as much power from the people as possible so that they can rule supreme over people, especially if before they do it in the next economic crash, blah, blah, blah. They won't do it. I believe they won't do it in one go. They'll do it time after time, little tiny steps. And when you say that to somebody, they go mental. Mental. They say, why do you think that? And I say, I've read history books from countries all around the world, not just the UK. And for some reason they think, well, that's not going to happen to the British government. What's wrong with you? And it's easy to rebuttal that by saying, is it illegal for politicians to lie? No. No, it's not. As soon as it's illegal to lie to the public, I might take it a little bit more seriously. Okay, number 15 and the final one, people who have a go at you for not having an opinion on something. As I said, I'm pretty stoic, both externally and internally, although this video hasn't really shown that. So I tend not to have an opinion on much. Can't help that, it's just the way I'm programmed. What do you think of when X did that thing to Y? Or what do you think of A and what they did to B? A hiccup during that. That was an awful time. What do you think of the situation X put on Y? Or better yet, the thing that A did to B? I don't have an opinion. Well, you should care about it. Well, I don't. But you should. But I don't. What they want me to do is either one of two things. Number one, they want me to side with them so that they could wave the flag of superiority and have the virtual signaling something, and they want me to be on their side. Or they want me to force a caring attitude towards a subject I don't care about and be incredibly deceptive of my approach to people and situations. Psychopaths do that. I'm not one of them. This happens a lot with friends talking about politics. What do you think of this? I don't care. Well, you should. Maybe you shouldn't. Ever thought of that? The thing I care about is when I can get my Iridium sprinklers in Stardew Valley, get into Memoria and Final Fantasy 9 in under 12 hours. These are the things I care about. Obviously, there are more things on my list than video games, but you get my point. Well, I only plan to do a couple of these kind of things, but the list just keep growing and growing as I was writing. So this is my 15 things that really grind my gears. And it turns out I'm human after all. Subscribe for more content. I'll see you all on Friday. Bye.